भारत हमको जान से प्यारा है, सबसे न्यारा गुलिस्तां हमारा है। भारत हमको जान से प्यारा है, सबसे न्यारा गुलिस्तां हमारा है। सदियों से भारत भूमि दुनिया की शान है, भारत माँ की रक्षा में जीवन कुर्बान है, भारत हमको जान से प्यारा है, सबसे न्यारा गुलिस्तां हमारा है। हिंदुस्तानी नाम हमारा है, सबसे प्यारा देश हमारा है, हिंदुस्तानी नाम हमारा है, सबसे प्यारा देश हमारा है, जन्मभूमि है हमारी शान से कहेंगे हम, सभी तो भाई भाई प्यार से रहेंगे हम, हिंदुस्तानी नाम हमारा है, सबसे प्यारा देश हमारा है।
सदके कोई धन है क्या तेरी धूल से बढ़ के, तेरी धूप से रोशन तेरी हवा पे जिंदा, तू बाग है मेरा मैं तेरा परिंदा।
केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल के कमांडेंट श्री भैरव प्रताप सिंह हमारे विद्यालय प्रांगण में पधार चुके हैं। हम अपने विद्यालय परिवार की ओर से उनका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं। वी देशमुख स्टेशन डायरेक्टर 1 और 2 हमारे विद्यालय प्रांगण में पधार चुके हैं। हम अपने विद्यालय परिवार की ओर से उनका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं।
We all know education should be accessible to all if democracy to succeed. Education is too powerful to reduce poverty, unemployment, improving health and nutritional standards and achieving sustainable development. Education brings economic, cultural as well as technological changes in the society. It is considered to be the most important means of enhancing personal attributes, overcome constraints, availing more opportunities for sustainable improvement in the well-being. Education has been identified as one of the most important determinants of economic growth. It is both an indicator and an instrument of development. India's digital payment have become one of our strengths. IT sector of India has created a record-breaking number of software engineers. Many Indians are on top positions in the biggest global companies like Sundar Pichai, CEO of Google, Indra Nooyi, CEO of PepsiCo, and one more proud example is our ACS Mumbai alumni Parag Agarwal, who has been appointed as Twitter's CEO. With the increased level of education, the economic output increased, poverty is reduced, and the whole of the region is developed, which leads to the overall development of the nation. India has launched PM Gati Shakti Master Plan that will integrate infrastructure, development and implementation. It will seamlessly connect goods, people and services. The New India not only aim on just social issues like casteism, riots and religions, but it looks forward to progressive India by urging people to think big, dream big and dedicate themselves to take the country to new heights of development and make 2022 a golden page in building new India. For that, government provided India with the path of self-reliance by easing the process and also incentivizing the investment and production.
जीवन और माल के लिए एक बड़ा संकट बन सकती है और अग्निशमक दल इस खतरे से बचाव करते हैं। अग्निशमन के लिए विशेष सामान और यंत्रों का प्रयोग भी होता है। इनमें पानी, आग निरोधक रसायन, विभिन्न प्रकार के अग्नि कवच, अग्निशमकों की आग निरोधक पोशाकें, जल गिराने वाले वाहन, अग्निशमकों के विशेष वाहन आदि शामिल हैं। दूसरा प्लाटून है केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल का, जिनका नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं असिस्टेंट सब इंस्पेक्टर श्री राजदीप भारती। केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल के तीसरे प्लाटून का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं असिस्टेंट सब इंस्पेक्टर श्री चंदन कुमार। CISF का गठन 1969 में किया गया था और आज CISF के जवानों की संख्या 2 लाख से ज़्यादा है। यहाँ मैं आपको बताना चाहूँगी कि केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल विश्व का सर्वोत्तम व्यवसाय औद्योगिक बल है। केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल यानी CISF देश की 300 से ज़्यादा औद्योगिक इकाइयों को सुरक्षा प्रदान करता है। परमाणु केंद्रों, अंतरिक्ष संयंत्रों, हवाई अड्डों, रिफाइनरी, ऊर्जा उत्पादन केंद्रों व पब्लिक सेक्टर यूनिट्स इत्यादि की सुरक्षा भी CISF के द्वारा ही की जाती है। काकरापार परमाणु ऊर्जा केंद्र की सुरक्षा भी हमारे CISF के सिपाही व अधिकारी बड़े ही कर्तव्य निष्ठा व ईमानदारी के साथ करते हैं। और अभी कुछ ही देर में हमारे मुख्य अतिथि महोदय आने वाले हैं। हम सभी उनका इंतजार कर रहे हैं। साथियों, जैसा कि हम सभी जानते हैं कि COVID-19 के कारण उपजी हुई परिस्थितियों के बाद देश के नागरिकों का सशक्तिकरण करने की आवश्यकता थी, ताकि वे देश से जुड़ी समस्याओं का समाधान कर सके तथा बेहतर भारत निर्माण करने में अपना योगदान दे सके। आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान के समक्ष अनेक चुनौतियां होने के बावजूद भारत को औद्योगिक क्षेत्र में मजबूती के लिए उन उद्यमों को निवेश करने की आवश्यकता है जिनमें भारत के वैश्विक ताकत के रूप में उभरने की संभावना है। इस दिशा में कार्य करते हुए सरकार ने आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान के अंतर्गत 20 लाख करोड़ रुपये के विशेष आर्थिक और व्यापक पैकेज की घोषणा की है। आत्मनिर्भर राहत पैकेज के माध्यम से न केवल सूक्ष्म, लघु एवं मध्यम उद्यमों के क्षेत्रों में भी सुधारों की घोषणा की गई है। प्रधानमंत्री मोदी ने कहा कि COVID-19 महामारी के कारण सारे विश्व में तालाबंदी है और सामान का आदान प्रदान नहीं हो पा रहा है। श्री एसके रॉय, स्टेशन डायरेक्टर 3 और 4, हमारे बीच पधार चुके हैं। हम अपने विद्यालय परिवार की ओर से उनका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं। प्रधानमंत्री मोदी ने कहा है कि COVID-19 महामारी के कारण सारे विश्व में तालाबंदी है और सामान का आदान प्रदान नहीं हो पा रहा है। इस समय में हमारी रोजमर्रा की जरूरतों को आसपास के छोटे मोटे दुकानदार पूरा कर रहे हैं। हमें ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा कोशिश करनी चाहिए कि हम अपने आसपास निर्मित वस्तुओं का प्रयोग करें और उनके उपयोग को प्रोत्साहित करें। लोकल सामान का इतना प्रचार करें कि वे ग्लोबल बन जाएं। इससे छोटे कारीगर और मजदूरों को प्रोत्साहन मिलेगा। इसे प्रधानमंत्री ने वोकल फॉर लोकल का नाम दिया। भारत की जनसंख्या में 18 से 35 वर्ष की आयु के लोग सबसे ज़्यादा हैं, इसलिए उन्हें वाइब्रेंट डेमोग्राफी नाम से संबोधित किया गया है। हमारे पास युवा शक्ति का विशाल भंडार है। इस जनसंख्या के भार को मुनाफे में तब्दील करने के लिए हमें लोगों को ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा काम देना होगा। उन्हें रोजगार तभी मिल सकता है जब हम लोकल निर्मित वस्तुओं का प्रयोग करें। मेड इन इंडिया और मेक इन इंडिया को बढ़ावा देकर भारत का सामान दूसरे देशों तक पहुंचाना है। आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान का मुख्य उद्देश्य सूक्ष्म, लघु एवं मध्यम वर्गीय गृह उद्योग को बढ़ावा देकर भारत से बेरोजगारी और गरीबी को खत्म करना है। MSME 12,000 करोड़ से ज़्यादा लोगों को रोजगार उपलब्ध कराता है। प्रधानमंत्री ने वसुधैव कुटुंबकम कहकर यह इशारा किया कि भारत तिहत्तरवें गणतंत्र दिवस समारोह के मुख्य अतिथि श्री एम वेंकटाचलम, केंद्र निदेशक काकरा पर परमाणु विद्युत गृह, हमारे बीच पधार चुके हैं। हम अपने विद्यालय परिवार की ओर से उनका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं। आप सभी से मेरा विनम्र निवेदन है कि वे राष्ट्रगान के लिए अपने अपने स्थान पर खड़े हो जाएं।
There is something in a soldier that makes him stand apart. There is a strength in soldier that comes from his heart. A soldier isn't a title any man can be hired to do. A soldier is the soul of that man buried deep inside of you. The fire contingents are always active and alert to avoid any fire tragedy at Kakrapa Atomic Power Station. The first platoon is Fire Brigade, headed by Shri K.G. Chauhan. The second platoon is CISF, headed by Shri Rajdeep Bhati, Assistant Sub-Inspector. The third platoon is CISF, headed by Shri Chandan Kumar, Assistant Sub-Inspector.
और अब मैं मुख्य अतिथि महोदय से विनम्र निवेदन करना चाहूंगी कि वे 73वें गणतंत्र दिवस का संदेश देकर हमें कृतार्थ करें।
नमस्कार श्री शरण प्रोजेक्ट डायरेक्टर स्टेशन डायरेक्टर्स सुनील कुमार रॉय देशमुख जी चीफ सुपरिंटेंडेंट सीसीई सुपरिंटेंडेंट्स ग्रुप हेड्स कमांडेंट प्रिंसिपल मैडम आशाबेन द ब्रेव लेडी ऑफ आवर टाउनशिप All my colleagues, teachers, some of the parents, and all my colleagues who are present here also seeing this program online through various medias or other means, and all my dear township inmates. Very good morning wishes to each and every one of you, and also let me convey my 73rd Republic Day greetings to each and every one of you. Well, it's not a simple celebrations. Just I'll have to stop with only that 73rd greetings, and then there are a lot of other things to cherish or discuss or ponder over. So I'll have to take some really good amount of time to discuss all these things. Before that, let me just start with congratulating our Madam Ashaben, who has really demonstrated what is the real meaning of that woman power? I will put it that way, very, very simply. Thank you very much, madam. I convey my appreciation, congratulations, and then recognition to you. And then you have really set an example that what we really mean when it comes to our colleagues. So thank you so much for your act. And then I say that rather than praising, I thought that let us emulate something from this. That's what I would like to request. So this is the first thing. Second thing, in spite of these COVID restrictions, within the protocols, and then our team, headed by E&US and then other members, and then school principal madam, and then their support staff have really nicely arranged this. And I'm able to see that whatever the conditions or the stipulations have been given, we are able to conduct this program. That also gives me some happiness. So with this, let us get into the discussion, what I have told initially. To start with, let me make it very clear that it is not a single celebration. It is a tri-celebrations for me today. Till today morning, I was thinking it is a twin celebrations. Today morning, I decided that with the message which what I got, it is a tri-celebrations. The first and foremost is it is a 73rd Republic Day, and then all of you are aware, and then definitely we'll have to cherish that. Because being in such a big nation of democratic with all the powers of expression, probably nobody else in this world has got. The second reason to cherish today is it is also the day of our year of Azadi ka Amrut hum log bolta hai. Kya hai? That 75th year of our independence. We have been celebrating a lot of things and then conducting large number of programs. Our training superintendent, I love to really salute that man, that he has taken a lot of initiatives, and then headed by him, the committee is doing a wonderful job. And there are several definitions in view of this Azadi ka Amrut, people are coining. So I also thought that today, from the nuclear family or from the nuclear operator, I would like to say that, freedom is having different definitions. For us, for the people, those are in DAE or NPCL, I can say that it is a state of being free from harmful effects of radiation. So let me come to the third part, which I do not know any of you could guess it or not. This is today morning I got this information. Our Kakrapara unit, unit 1, to date has registered 5.64 million units. It is precisely 235 megawatt. And it is in the history of Kakrapara, this is the highest generation actually. So morning at the moment when I got that 5 o'clock, that immediately I have decided that yes, it is a third celebration, so I'll have to include it. That is what I have done it now. So I am also joining all the colleagues of not only at Kakrapara 1 and 2, in the entire site and then township, in joining them in celebrating this happy occasion. So these are tri-celebrations. Definitely we'll have to take it along and then discuss a lot. So as a customary or a tradition, let me start with some of the events or the good things or what we have done at the site, and these are all the tradition. And then this time, I would like to be little different from that, not from the tradition, from our approach. The points what I have selected for discussion, maybe it may be a little puzzling, and I thought that, okay, it is better to do that way. As a customary, normally we'll start from that national level achievements. I thought that this time let us start from some international level achievements, because that is also a point of relevance to all of us, especially for the people of India. The one incident or one happening which has really, really made me to feel very, very happy about is the Conference of Parties 26 discussions, which has happened between November 1st to 13th at UK, Glasgow. And there are about some 200 countries have participated in that. And it is about limiting the climate temperature or climate change, I will put it. And the whole idea is that to limit the temperature rise by 1.5 degrees centigrade. There are a lot of things to discuss about it. And then one important or couple of important things are 153 countries, first time they have vowed that understanding the importance that these net zero, the carbon emission, we will achieve. Of course, the time what they have given is different, but 153 countries have vowed is a very big achievement actually. And then we are able to see a very clear actions in this regard actually. The reason is that the developed countries have decided to mobilize about $100 billion, that is about some 7.3 lakh crores every year towards this objective. And there are several things to cherish, and then of course let me come to that Indian point of view. Our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has given some 5 points or that 5 declarations in that, which is very important for our people, especially for the young countries like India. The first and foremost is that we'll be generating 5 lakh megawatt of electricity from the non-fossil fuels. This is the first declaration he has made. The second declaration what he has made is that 50% of our entire energy consumption from non-fossil fuels. It's an amazing target actually, having the faith on all of us on behalf of 139 crores of Indians. He made this declaration, and then we are sure that we'll be able to meet. And then third declaration is also very important, the 45% of that carbon intensity GDP reduction. It's also a big target. And the fourth one is another one is that 1 billion tons of carbon dioxide emission reductions. And the fifth one is the very important thing for the country like India, which is such a huge population, we are in the face of development or developing state. He made a very clear prediction and then declared that by 2070, we'll be net carbon zero country. So this is called the Panjamirtha. That is the name they have given, Panjamirtha. Really, I mean that because we know that our average age of our country is something around some 27 to 28 years. And for the country like us, we are going to rule. So this is very important. So there are several points to take from this Conference of Parties 26. And only one message I'll take from that, which really attracted me, which has come from one small youngster when they have given a speech. They say that if you want your coming generations to exist and live in this universe, please protect the universe. This is what they have told. So that the message is very clear. it is not somebody's job. Everyone has got a role in playing it, actually. Everyone has to contribute. Either you have to execute, or you have to demand, or you have to do something, or you have to follow, but it is everybody's importance that protecting the climate is the first and foremost important thing. This is the message I have taken from the international happening. Let me now come down to our country level. So there are a lot of things. Of course, I'm not going to talk about pandemic now. I'm going to tell about it at the end. And the first message is something different this time I have taken. It is really amazing to know that the startups which India has emerged in is really, 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 I don't have words to express actually. The youngsters are really surging ahead, and then the startups which India has seen in the last year is something amazing. So you'll be surprised to know that there are 83 unicorn companies have started in India. Unicorn means the company worth of more than $1 billion, something about some 7,000 crores at the time of startup, and then you are sustaining it. And 83 number of companies of unicorn and then several other companies is a big, big, big achievement. And not only that, in India we are all doing it, and then if you take the case of US, last year they have started about some 507 unicorn companies, out of which 91 companies are by Indians. So that means 18% of the unicorn companies started in US is by the people of Indian origin. And another one important message in this is that there are several companies, they are having a direct contact with India. All these companies, most of the companies. So these are all the very clear indications that our younger team is ready to take over from us, and then they are really, they want something different. And then they know that how to take along. That is why I said that the climate change and then protecting the universe and then giving the good universe to my youngsters is more important than anything else. So this is the first message I have taken from the what has happened at the country level. The second message I thought of just registering here at the country level is the way in which we have vaccinated our population. Today morning I have seen that at 5:30, till today morning, 162.5 crores of vaccinations have been administered. It's not a simple number. We have started late, but we have overtaken everybody. And 49.6, almost close to 50% of Indian population is completely vaccinated. It is an amazing result, I will say that, within the period of, say, 5 to 6 months. And then it's not only that it is an amazing result, and it is taken care very systematically so as to cover all the aspects of these vaccination requirements. So I really, on behalf of this everyone here, as well as from the Kakrapora Gujarat side, place on my appreciations to the entire health care people, doctors, nurses, and then all the people associated with to register our recognition and then appreciation to them. This is another one small message I have taken from that, and then it is a very important message. Now let me come back to our site level. Already I have told you that our Kakrapona Unit 1 and 2, our workhorses are really doing very well. And there are some couple of points I'll have to really bring out here to tell that how good they are all doing it. The first and foremost is that last year also, like earlier years, the capacity factor is about some 91%, and we have generated about 3,498 million units. And not only that, another one interesting result I have come across when I was just going through some time before, and then it is about some 68,722 million units we have generated till December end. And one important thing is that the overall capacity factor, if you see that for the similar units like us, we are really doing very well. So that way I am very happy, and not only in the area of production, I can say that radiological or industrial or fire safety, you name anything, they have been doing very well actually. And fire-free days alone, I'll just give one small example. It is about some 2,576 days of fire-free days. That is a very big number, and then I really congratulate all the people, those have contributed, and then those have been sustaining the safety and then production simultaneously at Kakrapora 1 and 2. Now let me come to Kakrapora 3. Let us first appreciate that it is a first-of-a-kind unit. And we have successfully come out, and then we have done a lot of activities. Of course, we got into the ordeal of some temperature issues and then some of the structural issues. But the good news is that the people sitting here are present here at the site as well as from the headquarters. They have successfully come out with a very, very implementable and the nice solution, which has cleared all the review process and expertise, everything. And we are about to start our implementation. Maybe if my prediction goes right, and then SD and PD are sitting here. Within a week or so, they'll be starting that modifications. It's a major modification, of course. Yes, as I said, it's a little bit of experiment, or it's a first of a kind reactor. Let us understand that. These people are really working or struggling very hard to come out of it, and then I really congratulate them for finding out a solution so quickly for this such a major problem, I will say that. So once if that is started, my prediction is that by about some couple of months, 2 to 3 months, they will come out, and then I have a lot of confidence on my team, actually. How that Kakrapara 3 and 4, the team of construction and then commissioning, together they are working along with the headquarter support. Coming to Kakrapara 4, we are inching towards hydro, and then if my predictions are correct, and then it is going to see a lot of activities this year, actually. There are going to be a lot of activities, and then like the way we were doing it some couple of years before, then Unit 3, large number of commissionings and then several milestones. The days are not far off to see that. It's not only that we have done well only in the Unit 1, 2, 3, 4, something like that. That common groups have also done very well. I'll have to talk something about HR, CMM, finance, our CASF, and then security, and then all other aspects, schools, EMG, everybody. Just I'll take some one or two examples to tell that what great work these teams have done. The first thing what I would like to say is that NSG commandos, National Security Guard commandos exercise, which was done here for probably the first time such an elaborate exercise. 3 days this exercise was done here, and they have really given a very good results, actually. I will say that first of a kind that this has been done, the coordinated way our HR and then CASF, they have done this along with the support of all other people, is really wonderful thing to discuss, actually. And this has happened. That has very clearly demonstrated that in case of requirement or in case of a need, we are well protected, and then our safety is always assured. So thank you so much for all the people those are involved in this, actually. It is not only that HR has gone ahead with our recruitment process, and then further they have carried on, and then they are in the process of just finalizing the list, and then once that comes, the manpower in Kakrapara site will be much better than any other site, I will say that. So CMM finance also, they have done a lot of things. At least one small example I would like to tell about finance, because which we only appreciate overall. This time I thought that I'll have to tell a small thing about that finance. They have streamlined several things. I'm not going into the detail. The way the auditing is done and then presented, it is a very clear procedure now. And they are able to do it within the time, though there are constraints. And one more important thing I would like to present here, which made me really to feel happy about it, is that their money management is so perfect that this whole year, we have not even listened even a single day that, yes, there is a requirement of money has to come or it has to be deposited or something. Whatever bill you are asking that they were processing, because their management is so fine. So let us appreciate each and every activity which is happening at the site. Then only the site will cherish, actually. And let me come down to now township. Definitely a lot of things have been done. You are seeing that lot of small facelift activities and other things. As we are discussing the good things, we also should have the heart, and then we should accept that something untoward has happened at our township, and then I don't have any hesitation in telling that yes, to some extent we have missed something. And this was a real eye-opener, but still, all the incident though it has happened, that we are very closely following with the state officials. Even the last week also I had some discussions, and we will not leave it. We will not give up, and then we'll continue to do that. I am sure that with the support of the CASF security and then all of you, we'll be able to make some breakthrough. And it is a real eye-opener. It made us to think in the different directions to give some more our security protections or something to our township. So our EMG has really come up with a very good plan and then execution, strengthening that boundary, making the pathways, and then providing that additional concertina wires, lighting, these are so many things I can tell. But one important thing is that they have done it very quickly this time, and then really I myself got shocked, actually, within that such a short time, how they were able to do that. Understanding the importance, they have done all these things. And it is not only that, one more important thing which I love to tell here with respect to the township, our dream of 10 years, that additional water supply line to our township, which has been approved by the state government, and then letter of intent has already been issued, and then contractor has already come to that. This is 10 years we have been struggling to get it, and then the team headed by our ENDUS and then all the people, they have seen that, yes, it is materialized, actually. So there are a lot of things to talk about EMG or the township or the common groups, and then now Let me come to the hospital. I'll have to take really couple of minutes here to talk about hospital. The reason is, when everybody was talking about third wave, to start with, we have also started, we also thought, we discussed a lot, but the way in which the various committees and then hospital team, they have aligned themselves and then they have seen, the third wave itself has wavered actually. It has weathered down. Though there was some effect initially, afterwards we have been kept so comfortable because of the support of every one of you and then the effective teams from the hospital and then other teams headed by various senior people. Really they have protected well and then we have not been really subjected to such a harsh situation. Really I'll have to congratulate and then compliment everybody who has done this wonderful work so that our community is kept in happiness. Other thing which I would like to tell about this hospital, that some of couple of points, and then we have now commissioned our oxygen plant, the first in NPCL, and then probably, I don't know, in the whole DAE, we may be the first people. The way that various teams have collaborated and then done it, and which has made available that oxygen facility for us, and even we can go up to some 35 to 40 beds at simultaneously, is a wonderful thing, actually. And it has been done very quickly, and then the system is already ready. One more thing I'll have to tell here, that yesterday only we have just inaugurated along with all my directors that OPG, ortho pantomogram, the panoramic view of what they have told, actually I read something, maxilla and mandible or something like lower and upper jaw. That we'll be able to see the panoramic view of this and then with a single shot, and then this facility is not available in the entire Tapi district, but our hospital is having. And I have been told that only a couple of hospitals in Surat only is having this. Other than that, nobody else is having this facility. So that is the eagerness our hospital team is having to, support or to protect us or whatever you call it as. And over and above that also, there are some other points that the way that the hospital projects are streamlined and then empanelment has been done. I'll have to compliment hospital management committee, hospital empanelment committee, as well as that medical superintendent and our team. The way they have done it, I'm very confident that we'll never come across the problem of that any referral or anything else or any other support or any medical assistance is required. So overall in all the areas it is going on very well, and then school also I got some points. The way the online classes were going on with the very good results, I'll have to compliment the teachers and then students, principal, everybody. More than that, one more group of people we'll have to compliment here, that is the parents, or specifically the mothers. The students are sitting at home and then still the results are coming good means. Equally, we'll have to give the compliments to all the mothers, those are present at the township. That is why it is possible actually. Otherwise, just imagine with a gadget, a kid is sitting in the home and the kid is doing well, is without the support of mother, it will not happen actually. So I would have taken some examples to explain what has happened at the site. Probably I would have missed several things or something like that. I do not know. And then school also, I remember that one of the global challenge competition or something, some quiz competition they have participated, and then our people have done well. And then I think two people have got into finals. Two students have got into finals, national level, something like that. So there are several things to discuss. And I take this opportunity to congratulate and compliment everybody who are at the site, both at the plant and then as well as at the township, those have contributed for seeing that the site is progressing well. And at this point, I would also like to recognize all the other activities which have been done at the site during this period. So now let me move on to the next part of it. As a tradition, we'll have to take one message. So I thought this time that what is the message I'll have to give? Definitely this pandemic, though it is in the process of just going out or it is in the process of staying, we do not know, but it has taught us a lot of things. And it has impacted everywhere. Industry, farming, education, economy, you name any sector, any area, you will see that there is an effect of it. And you see that any individual on the universe definitely has been affected or she has been affected by the pandemic. And as on today, the official figure is that 35.5 crore of people have been affected by this virus. The percentage is about some 5%, but other statistics indicate that easily 20% of the people would have been affected by this. And other thing is very wild, I do not know, maybe some medical professional can clarify. It says that almost everybody in the universe has come across this virus. Maybe some people have fought it out and then some people haven't fought it out, but at least some viral load everybody had seen. I don't know how far it is correct. I'm not an expert. I'm just telling what is available in the media. So this virus has touched every one of us, both physically as well as emotionally, and it has played its role. It has had a devastating role, and then it has really done so many things, and then it changed the way we are all thinking, actually. For a change, there is something called think from the opposite direction. Think totally negative. So I thought that, okay, let me take this exercise and then let me see that whether this pandemic has brought anything positive. Not that positive result, any positive benefits. You may suddenly think that site director has been so systematic so far in narrating everything, what happened to him? But I really mean it. Whether this pandemic has given any positive benefits to the human community. It is very important to think from both angles or all the angles or 360 degree view, we call it as. The reason is we have paid a big price and we should get some lessons out of it. And it's very costly lessons. And also I am a strong believer that when the God is testing something means definitely he is testing us only for giving some lesson. That is my belief actually. And beyond that, I will tell you one thing that there are predictions now, by all means this pandemic is going to be over by the year end. And next year it is going to be the totally normal. And there are other report which says that even if the pandemic survives by 2023, we all know that how to lead a normal life even with that. So both the results or both the studies say that we are going to lead a normal life either with pandemic or without pandemic or whatever way you call it. The virus may be there or may not be there, but our life will be normal. Once if that state is attained, what we'll think, you just imagine after 5 to 10 years down the line. After 10 years from now, though we have lost many lives and then there have been several devastating effects, when we discuss about pandemic, I am damn sure that everyone will have a story. Somebody will tell that I have added heavy water during that time and then how carefully I have gone and then added. Somebody will tell that how I overhauled the CCW pump, which motor failure was there during the peak of the pandemic. Somebody will tell that I have started that school and then online classes. Definitely medical professional has got a lot of stories. Everybody will have a story after 5 to 10 years to express once if we come out of this actually. And it is a human nature that though there are negative things, when somebody is talking about something which he has experienced, he has done, he will talk about his positive points. So I am damn sure because I have seen the tsunami after 5 or 10 years, how the people started talking about it, though there were effects and then people told about that what they have done during the tsunami to come out of it. Probably that is the right way to approach. So I thought that what positive effects it has brought, because after 5 to 10 years when we are discussing, we'll be talking only about some of the positive effects, I will put it that way. I may be wrong in my prediction. Some of the positive effects of this pandemic. So how to go about it? This question I have got some time before. You're wrong and then eccentric question, I will say that. I just asked some of my colleagues. It was very interesting answers I got. Very close colleagues, I have just asked some of the people. I got different answers. You'll be surprised, some people have told me that they started talking to their family more time after this actually. This is a fact, I am not exaggerating anything. Somebody told me that I started doing some exercises very regularly. Someone told that I have enrolled myself in the yoga. Pranayama I have started. They have told so many things, I am picking some 1 or 2 points which is more applicable or interesting to me. And one person has told me that the car I am planning to buy it in 2025 because of the pandemic, I have preponed it and then got it in 21. There are several answers and then one unique person from Neyveli, I got a very close friend, he is my college mate. He is a technical person, he is a technical engineer. So you should be very careful while talking to the technical people. He is a performance engineer, always he will talk hi-fi, fluidized bed, or hydrogen and hydrocarbons. magnetohydrodynamics, like that only he will talk something, whenever we talk actually. I'm a little afraid of talking to him because that's something you'll pick and then talk and then you'll be surprised to know that something new is there that which you are not knowing. I was very curious to talk to that fellow. I have prepared myself because technically what are all the new things are there I have gone through and then I have approached him. I have got a totally different answer. Such a technical person who has been always on the technical field, he has told me the first lockdown, before telling that he has told me one thing, I have not learned, I have been taught. That is how he has started. He told me that during the first lockdown, I learned how to make sambar, rasam and puriyal. Puriyal means it is a cooked sabji in South actually. He told the same thing I am telling you. I learned how to make sambar, rasam and puriyal. During the second wave, I have learned that how to operate the washing machine, the grinder, mixy, oven, these, that's so many things. And probably if there is a third wave and then I may master the homemaking, I'll be fit for retired life. But he is unlucky, he has not got the third wave yet. Probably I do not know whether he is lucky to get it again or not. Though it may look very witty, and you just imagine, a person who has been tasting the sambar for the past 54 years has been given an opportunity to learn how to make sambar because of this pandemic. Is it not that something unique which has happened in the world? Probably if it hasn't happened, throughout the life you wouldn't have learned how to make sambar. I'm not telling this making sambar is a great thing. It is one such example. Like that, several examples have happened on this universe. That's what I am trying to tell. So there is a clearly it has put us in a different perspective. And leaving all these things, scientifically I have taken this problem afterwards. What it has really taught us? What is the worth lesson I'll have to communicate to my team? That this pandemic has given you some positive lesson which you should never miss. So I have gone through some presentations and then studies. Several things have come to that and then only some 3 points I will take from that. The first and foremost points, and you can see that in several TEDx talks or in the presentations or in the even the reports it is given that the pandemic has made us to slow down some of our activities which we were not understanding so far. It made us to slow down ourselves in some of the activity which otherwise it is not required. Unnecessarily we were rushing those activities which are not required. This pandemic has really made us to slow down. You can just think and then imagine whether you have come across such things or not. Because I did a lot of thinking in this area and then I have realized, yes. This is the first thing. The second thing which it has made is that it made us to stay calm and then think deep about some of the very intrinsic problems. Maybe about your life, about your generations, or about your children, or about your study, or about your business, or about your unit, or about your project. It made you to stay calm and think very deep about it. This is the second finding. The third finding is very important, very, very important. It made most of the people to look at our habit and pursue it actually. Looking at our hobby and then pursuing it is very, very important because all the three what we have discussed now, slow down where it is not required, sit and then think deep and pursue our hobbies, are the basic requirements for the creativity. Probably the creativity quotient after the pandemic, if you take, definitely it has gone up. That is the reason that we are seeing as a result of what is it, all these startups. And I can quote several examples actually, because of this creativity index has gone up in several areas. The drone, we know that it is a danger, but our youngsters have proved that with the drone, the creativity is so high that now they have used it for the security. And they are using it for measuring the volume of the coal heaps in few minutes, which they were taking it earlier several days. And this drone, now it is used for, spraying pesticides. I don't have any doubt in that, the creativity quotient. In my opinion, if you just go through that, your own section, you see that there will be an improvement. And one great example I would like to give, how this hobby and then creativity are related, because I was also having a doubt of, once if you say hobby, how it will enhance the creativity. They have given an example from Albert Einstein. We all know that he is a great scientist, but he is the excellent violinist. How many of you are aware, I do not know. It is his hobby. and till last he has been pursuing it actually. Later his brain was analyzed and then lot of research was done. It was seen that there was a clear relation between that happy quadrant and then that creativity quadrant. It may look very funny if I just conclude that, okay, you just pursue your hobby, tomorrow you'll find out some equation equivalent to E is equal to MC square. No, I'm not telling that. But if you pursue hobby, your hobby truly, and it will give you so much of happiness that by default your creativity will go up. So this is a message I would like to give. Because of the pandemic, with the good or bad lessons, or with the good or bad process, we have learned one thing, that the three things which are important for pursuing our creativity is think deep, stay calm for some time, slow down where it is not required, pursue your hobbies. And by pursuing hobbies, by taking out some time, our creativity will go up. This let us keep it in mind, and then let us really take out some time to pursue our hobby. This is the message. With this, I compliment and congratulate each and every one of you, and then I convey my greetings to all of you once again. Thank you so much for making such a wonderful program and then giving me such a beautiful opportunity to share my views on this great day of our republic. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
माननीय मुख्य अतिथि महोदय, आपने काकरापार परमाणु विद्युत गृह, अनुमाला कॉलोनी, काकरापार अस्पताल और परमाणु ऊर्जा केंद्रीय विद्यालय की उपलब्धियों को बड़े ही सहज रूप में हमारे समक्ष रखा। हम आपके आभारी हैं व आशा करते हैं कि आपके नेतृत्व में काकरापार परमाणु विद्युत गृह नए नए कीर्तिमान स्थापित करेगा और हमारे विद्यालय के छात्र व छात्राएँ भी प्रगति के पथ पर अग्रसर होंगे। धन्यवाद माननीयवर।
द परेड कमांडर श्री पंकज कुमार सब इंस्पेक्टर हैज टेकन परमिशन फ्रॉम द चीफ गेस्ट फॉर द डिस्पर्सल ऑफ द परेड। द परेड इज बीइंग डिस्पर्स्ड।
गणतंत्र दिवस हमारा राष्ट्रीय पर्व है और इसे सभी धर्मों के लोग मिलजुल कर मनाते हैं। आज ही के दिन हमारा संविधान भी लागू हुआ था, जिसके अनुसार हमारा देश एक लोकतांत्रिक, संप्रभु तथा गणतंत्र देश घोषित किया गया। देश हुआ आज़ाद, बना कानून हमारा, देश बना प्रभुत्व संपन्न, ये गणराज्य हमारा। और अब गणतंत्र दिवस के उपलक्ष्य में अपने विचार आप सभी के साथ साझा करने आ रहे हैं कक्षा 5 से रिक बंदोपाध्याय। इनका मार्गदर्शन किया है श्रीमती संध्या वंजारी ने। रिक बंदोपाध्याय,
भारत के गणतंत्र का है सारे जग में मान, दशकों से खिल रही इसकी अद्भुत शान। सब धर्मों को देखकर मान रच गया इतिहास, हर भारतवासी को है गणतंत्र पर अटल विश्वास। नमस्ते, मंच पर आमंत्रित सभी अतिथिगण, शिक्षकों और मेरे साथियों, आप सभी को मेरी ओर से 73वें गणतंत्र दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। मेरी बंद पाद है कक्षा 5 से इस अवसर पर कुछ कहने आया हूँ। मेरे शिक्षकों को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद जिन्होंने मुझे इस अवसर पर कुछ बोलने का मौका दिया। 26 जनवरी हम देशवासियों के लिए अति शुभ एवं गौरवपूर्ण दिन है। हम सब जानते हैं कि 15 अगस्त 1947 को भारत स्वतंत्र हुआ, परंतु जब तक संविधान न रचा जाए तब तक स्वतंत्रता अधूरी रह जाती है। डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर जी के नेतृत्व में स्वतंत्र भारत का संविधान रचा गया और उसे 26 जनवरी 1950 यानी आज के दिन ही लागू किया गया। ये दिन हमें स्वतंत्रता संग्राम और स्वतंत्रता सेनानियों की याद दिलाता है। पूर्ण स्वराज मिलने के बाद भारत दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा लोकतांत्रिक देश बना। हम भाग्यशाली हैं कि हमारा जन्म स्वतंत्र भारत में हुआ। इस भारत में सभी नागरिकों को 6 मौलिक अधिकार दिए जाते हैं, जो है समानता का अधिकार, स्वतंत्रता का अधिकार, शोषण के विरुद्ध अधिकार, धर्म की स्वतंत्रता का अधिकार, सांस्कृतिक और शिक्षा का अधिकार एवं संविधानिक उपचार का अधिकार। लेकिन जैसे ही हम अपने अधिकारों का आनंद लेते हैं, वैसे ही हमें अपने राष्ट्र के प्रति हमारी जिम्मेदारियों को भी पूरा करना चाहिए। आगे बढ़कर गरीबी, बेरोजगारी, निरक्षरता आदि सामाजिक आर्थिक मुद्दों से अवगत होना चाहिए। भारत तेजी से विकास की राह पर बढ़ रहा है। कोविड-19 महामारी के दौरान भारत ने 3 टीके विकसित किए, जिनमें से 2 का उपयोग किया जा रहा है। हमने 1 साल से भी कम समय में टीकों की 150 करोड़ खुराकें पूरी कर ली। वैज्ञानिकों का अनुमान था कि इस लक्ष्य तक पहुंचने में 10 साल लगेंगे। भारत सबसे अधिक जनसंख्या वाले देशों में से भी एक है, पर तभी भी हम अनाज के मामले में आत्मनिर्भर है। टोक्यो ओलंपिक 2020 में भारत ने 7 पदक और पैरालंपिक 2020 में 19 पदक हासिल किए। भारत दुनिया की सबसे शक्तिशाली सेना बनाने का लक्ष्य लेकर भी चल रहा है। स्वदेशी वाहन वाहक विक्रांत ने परीक्षा के 3 चरण में प्रवेश किया है और परमाणु ऊर्जा से चलने वाली पनडुब्बी अरंत भी लॉन्च किया गया है। भारत हरित शक्ति की यात्रा पर भी आगे बढ़ रहा है। 2031 तक भारत ने 22,480 मेगावाट परमाणु ऊर्जा उत्पन्न करने की योजना बनाई है। 2024 तक 9 नए रिएक्टर चालू होने जा रहे हैं। भारत जल्द ही दुनिया के दरबार में एक स्वर्ण सिंहासन प्राप्त करेगा, क्योंकि ये देश है महापुरुषों का, ये देश है गुणी विद्वानों का, ये देश है साधु संतों का, ये देश है वीर बलवानों का, ये देश है वीर बलवानों का। आज हमें विविधता के बीच एकता एवं समानता बनाए रखने के अपनी प्रतिबद्धताओं का पालन करना चाहिए। मैं उन सभी स्वतंत्रता सेनानियों को सलाम करना चाहता हूँ जिन्होंने भारत को आज़ाद करने में जी जान लगा दी। हमें भी अपने राष्ट्र के प्रति सर्वश्रेष्ठ नौछावर कर देने के लिए तैयार रहना चाहिए और देश के चरम उत्कर्ष तक पहुँचने का संकल्प लेना चाहिए। 200 साल की गुलामी के बाद हमें ये स्वतंत्रता मिली है। इसे बरकरार रखने की जिम्मेदारी हम सब की है। ये देश की जिम्मेदारी नहीं है कि हमें आगे ले जाए, बल्कि ये हमारी जिम्मेदारी है कि हम देश को आगे ले जाए, राष्ट्र को आगे ले जाए, वतन को आगे ले जाए। हम देश में जात पात भाषा आदि के विभेद के बीच पनपने ना देंगे। एकता के सतरंग में हम भारत को सजाएंगे। अंत में मैं यही कहना चाहूँगा कि जिए तो इसी के लिए, यही भी मान रहे सहर्ष, नौछावा कर दे सर्वस्व, हमारा प्यारा भारतवर्ष, हमारा प्यारा भारतवर्ष। जय हिंद, वंदे मातरम।
धन्यवाद रिक। वास्तव में सच्चा देशभक्त अपनी मातृभूमि की रक्षा के लिए अपना सर्वस्व अर्पित कर देता है। अपनी मातृभूमि के प्रति ऐसा प्रेम केवल इंसानों में ही नहीं वरन पशु पक्षियों में भी पाया जाता है। यहाँ मुझे कवि की कुछ पंक्तियाँ याद आ रही हैं। इन पंक्तियों में कवि पक्षियों को संबोधित करते हुए कहता है, आग लगी इस वृक्ष में, जल गए इसके पात, तुम क्यों जलते पक्षियों जब पंख तुम्हारे पास। पक्षी कवि के इस प्रश्न का बहुत ही भावपूर्ण उत्तर देते हुए कहते हैं, फल खाए इस वृक्ष के बीट लथेड़े पात, फल खाए इस वृक्ष के बीट लथेड़े पात, धर्म हमारा यही है जल जाए इसी के साथ। अपनी मातृभूमि के प्रति प्रेम का इससे बड़ा उदाहरण और क्या हो सकता है। एक बार फिर से तुम्हारा धन्यवाद रिक। और बढ़ते हैं अपने अगले कार्यक्रम की ओर। हम हिंदुस्तानी पूरी मेहनत, लगन, कर्मठता और क्रियाशीलता के साथ कठिन से कठिन कार्य को भी पूरा करने का हौसला रखते हैं। जब हम किसी कार्य को करने की ठान लेते हैं तो उसे पूरा करके ही दम लेते हैं। फिर चाहे कितनी भी मुश्किलें आए, हम हिंदुस्तानी पीछे नहीं हटते हैं। किसी ने सही कहा है, वो खुद ही तय करते हैं मंजिल आसमानों की, वो खुद ही तय करते हैं मंजिल आसमानों की, परिंदों को नहीं दी जाती तालीम उड़ानों की। रखते हैं जो हौसला आसमां छूने का, उनको नहीं परवाह गिर जाने की, उनको नहीं परवाह गिर जाने की। इसी जज्बे, जोश, उमंग और उत्साह से भरा है हमारा आज का देशभक्ति गीत हम हिंदुस्तानी। आप सभी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। बहुत ही सुंदर प्रस्तुति थी। इस उमंग और उत्साह से भरे गीत को प्रस्तुत किया था हमारे विद्यालय की अध्यापिकाओं ने, जिनके नाम हैं श्रीमती संध्या वंजारी, श्रीमती स्वाति चौधरी, श्रीमती रितु सिंह और श्रीमती सबिया फातिमा। इन सभी अध्यापिकाओं का मार्गदर्शन किया है हमारे विद्यालय के संगीताचार्य श्री संजय उपासनी सर ने।
It is said that speech is the mirror of the soul. As it speaks, so is it. Now, I would like to invite Swara Swagya from class 8A to express her views on this Republic Day.
With freedom and sovereignty in minds, with faith and confidence in words, with sacrifices of martyrs in memories, with saga of valor in our heart, let us salute our nation on its 73rd Republic Day. A very warm good morning to all of you. Honorable Chief Guest, Shri M. Venkatachalam, Site Director, Kakrapar, Gujarat Site, other dignitaries, LMC members, special invitees, guests, teachers, and dear friends. Today, India proudly celebrates its 73rd Republic Day during this ongoing Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav under the safe heaven, safe sky and safe waters. India, the largest democracy in the world, became a republic on 26 January 1950. It was a triumph of hope, optimism and idealism. It was freedom blessed by supreme sacrifices of countless martyrs. It was on this day that the Constitution of India was formally adopted by the Parliament. The day 26 January was chosen to honor the memory of Declaration of Independence of 1930. This was the very day when we became a sovereign democratic republic and the Constitution of India came into force. The unfurling of the national tricolor by Dr. Rajendra Prasad heralded the historic birth of Indian Republic. The transition of India from a British colony to a sovereign, secular and democratic nation was indeed historic. On this patriotic and nationalistic day, we recollect thousands of freedom fighters who voluntarily came forward to participate in the noble task of making India a democratic nation. We also pay rich tributes to the unsung and uncelebrated martyrs whose contribution was not less than other patriots. We recall with profound reverence their inspiring deeds which made us see the beautiful dawn of 26 January 1950. On this sacred occasion, we remember Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who gave us the longest written constitution, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who worked for an industrialized India, Gandhiji, who taught us non-violence and ahimsa, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, who inducted courage and heroism in us, Sardar Patel, who kept India united, and Swami Vivekanand, who gave us divine and spiritual power. Dear friends, remembering the valiant and courageous past of India, let us now talk about the competency and achievements of present India. Recently, the whole world faced a major crisis and setback in form of COVID-19. In 2020, when COVID-19 began, we did not have sufficient essentials like masks, PP kits, sanitizers, etc. But today, due to our Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, we are the largest producers of PP kits and many life-saving drugs. Now, we have sufficient beds, ventilators, and intensive care units in all our hospitals. We proudly say that India is fighting the third wave of corona like no other nation in the world, and with the support from medical fraternity and countrymen, we will defeat corona pandemic through mask, vaccination and social distancing. On this special day, we also pay our sincere gratitude to all our scientists, virologists and doctors for producing the most effective indigenous vaccines, Covaxin and Covishield, which are saving lakhs of people in India and across the globe. India took one more giant leap in its fight against COVID-19 by commencing vaccination program for 15 to 18 age group. And as on date, India has vaccinated more than 10 crore children. We are confident that with the acceleration of COVID vaccination program, India will certainly stand victorious in its battle against the deadly global pandemic. India will soon launch Molnupiravir, world's first anti-COVID oral medicine approved by US FDA and Drugs Controller General of India. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in his address to the nation on 25th December 2021, said that India will soon start administration of nasal vaccines and the world's first DNA vaccine against COVID-19. Today, amid increasing COVID-19 cases due to the Omicron variant of the virus, I take this opportunity to appeal all people of KPS Township to remain vigilant and follow COVID-appropriate behavior by avoiding unnecessary gatherings, maintaining social distancing, using masks and sanitizing hands regularly. When it comes to international diplomacy and humanitarian help during the pandemic, it is indeed true that we have supplied essential medicines and COVID vaccines to over 150 countries. We are also the third largest producers of pharma medicines. Apart from celebrating our sovereign republic, it is also time for each of us to ask ourselves how we could make our country more prosperous and secure. We are a country blessed with natural resources, vibrant people, and dazzling cultural legacy. When it comes to progress, growth, and development, it is indeed true that we have made a considerable progress in these 75 years. India's growth rate has been impressive. We have made a considerable progress from agricultural production to nuclear and space technology, from affordable healthcare to world-class educational institutions, from Ayurveda to biotechnology, from giant steel plants to becoming an IT power and having the third largest startup ecosystem in the world. Dear friends, defense and military warfare, we can face territorial disputes against China and Pakistan with all our might after the delivery of Rafale fighter jets. The inclusion of 83 indigenously built Tejas fighter planes will further intensify India's resolve to safeguard and protect herself from enemy countries with undying spirits. Today, all countrymen can be rest assured that with induction of Rafale fighter jets, India will crush the nefarious and unholy expansion plans of our neighbors. In military preparedness, I proudly say that we are the third largest army and fourth largest air force in the world. We are also the second largest contributor to the United Nations peacekeeping force. Our governmental schemes such as Skill India, Digital India, Make in India, Swachh India, Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana, Adarsh Gram Yojana, Ayushman Bharat Yojana and Atmanirbhar Bharat Yojana have taken India to new heights of growth and economic development. When many developed countries are facing severe economic crisis due to COVID-19, India has regained its economic growth. When industrial giants are collapsing and people are losing jobs worldwide, India still stands tall with its sustainable growth rate of 8.3%. Other than countless success stories and achievements of India, we also have some major concerns that need to be resolved. The greatest challenges faced by India are cross-border terrorism, Chinese incursions on the LSE, ceasefire violations by Pakistani rangers, and regular infiltration attempts by Pak-sponsored terror outfits to destabilize the unity and social fabric of a country. Apart from external threats, we also have some unresolved issues within our country. Farmers protest, violence by Naxalites, unemployment, child labor, poverty, economic disparity, floods, price rise, environmental degradation, and the demon of corruption, mother of all problems. The younger generation today faces challenges graver than any which their forefathers did. And I am sure that the youth of India have muscles of iron and nerves of steel. They are an immense reservoir of strength and power. It is they who play a major role in shaping India's destiny. And I also believe that they will rededicate themselves for the task of nation building to restore oneness, peace, harmony and brotherhood. And now I conclude my speech with a dream of India that is united in thoughts, not divided by religion and language. India that is united in Indianness, not divided by caste. India that is united in seeking new opportunities for growth and development. India that is caring and inclusive. Come, let us together build a progressive and vibrant India. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, Swara. Your views are really inspiring and motivating. This reminded me of few lines by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, that I will keep the lamp of knowledge burning to achieve the vision developed India. If we work and sweat for great vision with ignited minds, the transformation leading to the birth of vibrant India will happen.
और अब समय है पुरस्कार वितरण का. आज के पुरस्कार वितरण समारोह में सर्वप्रथम हम एक साहसी, निडर, निर्भय व पराक्रमी महिला को उनके उत्कृष्ट व जोखिम भरे बहादुर कार्य के लिए पुरस्कृत करेंगे. मित्रों, आपको ज्ञात होगा कि हमारी अनुमाला टाउनशिप में दिवाली की छुट्टियों के दौरान चोरी की वारदातें हुई थी. 21 नवंबर 2021 की मध्य रात्रि के समय कुछ असामाजिक व पेशेवर चोरों के द्वारा C66 ब्लॉक में एक बड़ी चोरी की वारदात को अंजाम दिया जा रहा था. तभी ताला तोड़कर दरवाज़ा खोलने की आवाज़ से श्रीमती आशाबेन पटेल नींद से जागी तथा बड़ी बहादुरी व सतर्कता के साथ चोरों का सामना किया. इनकी तत्परता, साहस व जोखिम भरे सामाजिक उत्तरदायित्व की वजह से चोरी की वारदात निष्क्रिय हो गई तथा चोरों को वहाँ से भागना पड़ा. आज श्रीमती आशाबेन पटेल को उनकी बहादुरी, कर्मठता व कर्तव्य निष्ठा के लिए पुरस्कृत किया जा रहा है. श्रीमती आशाबेन पटेल सभी नारियों के लिए एक प्रेरणा स्रोत हैं. मैं मुख्य अतिथि महोदय से अनुरोध करना चाहूँगी कि वह अपने कर कमलों के द्वारा श्रीमती आशाबेन पटेल को उनके अदम्य साहस व बहादुरी के लिए पुरस्कृत करें. मैं प्रधानाचार्य डॉक्टर नीना बुपैया मैम से भी अनुरोध करती हूँ कि वे मुख्य अतिथि महोदय को पुरस्कार वितरण करने में अपना सहयोग प्रदान करें. और अब मैं श्रीमती आशाबेन पटेल से विनम्र निवेदन करती हूं कि वे मंच पर आकर अपना पुरस्कार ग्रहण करें. मैं आप सभी को बताना चाहूंगी कि श्रीमती आशाबेन पटेल को उनकी बहादुरी के लिए केंद्र निदेशक महोदय के द्वारा एक प्रशस्ति पत्र भी प्रदान किया गया था. सभी यहाँ पर उपस्थित सभी से मेरा अनुरोध है कि वे खड़े होकर श्रीमती आशाबेन पटेल के लिए के सम्मान में तालियां बजाएं. और अब मैं औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल के उन जवानों को आमंत्रित करना चाहूँगी जिन्होंने इस गणतंत्र दिवस समारोह में अपना महत्वपूर्ण योगदान प्रदान किया है. सर्वप्रथम मैं आमंत्रित करना चाहूँगी केंद्रीय सुरक्षा बल के परेड कमांडर श्री पंकज कुमार, सब इंस्पेक्टर. कृपया मंच पर आएं और मुख्य अतिथि महोदय से अपना पुरस्कार प्राप्त करें. केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल के प्लाटून नंबर 1 के कमांडर श्री चंदन कुमार, असिस्टेंट सब इंस्पेक्टर, कृपया मंच पर आएं और मुख्य अतिथि महोदय से अपना पुरस्कार प्राप्त करें. श्री आर दुर्गा प्रसाद, कांस्टेबल. केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल के कांस्टेबल श्री विश्वजीत घोष. केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल के प्लाटून नंबर 2 के कमांडर श्री चक्रधारी पांडे, श्री चक्रधारी पांडे कांस्टेबल, नेक्स्ट केंद्रीय सुरक्षा केंद्रीय औद्योगिक सुरक्षा बल प्लाटून नंबर 2 के कमांडर श्री शिव शंकर गोरई कांस्टेबल, नेक्स्ट श्री विश्व श्री पंकज अंतिल सब इंस्पेक्टर, श्री पंकज अंतिल अब मैं श्री आर शरण प्रोजेक्ट डायरेक्टर को से निवेदन करती हूं कि वे कैडेट्स को पुरस्कार देकर सम्मानित करें। श्री आर शरण, और अब अग्निशमक दल के कमांडर श्री केजी चौहान सब ऑफिसर B1,
नेक्स्ट इज LH चावड़ा फायरमैन B, एंडी गामित लीडिंग फायरमैन, फुट पायलट्स फ्रॉम CISF श्री रोहित कुमार, फुट पायलट CISF श्री भारत भूषण, फ्लैगमैन CISF श्री जे सुरेंद्र सिंह सब इंस्पेक्टर, ड्रमर CISF श्री लार्ड SK हेड कांस्टेबल,
और अब मैं श्री AB देशमुख स्टेशन डायरेक्टर 1 और 2 से विनम्र निवेदन करती हूँ। इसके साथ ही श्री SK रॉय स्टेशन डायरेक्टर 3 और 4 से मैं निवेदन करती हूँ कि वे प्रतिभागियों को पुरस्कार प्रदान करें। और अब संगीत अध्यापक परमाणु ऊर्जा केंद्रीय विद्यालय श्री संजय उपासनी PRT म्यूजिक, और अब हिंदी वक्ता रिक बंदोपाध्याय क्लास 5B, नेक्स्ट स्वरा सवज्ञा अंग्रेजी वक्ता क्लास 8A,
और आज की इंग्लिश एंकर मिसेस कीर्ति यादव। और इनका साथ दिया है मिसेस सरिता सिंह मैम ने.
Moving on to the next program.
सभी अतिथियों का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
Moving on to the next program, it is the beautiful and melodious national song. So I would like to invite teachers Mrs. Sandhya Vanjari, Mrs. Swati Chaudhary, Mrs. Ritu Singh and Mrs. Sabiha Fatima to fill the charisma in the aura by their melodious voices. I request all to join this song. An awesome and graceful performance. At last, I would like to say, let not pass this Republic Day as any other holiday. Instead, look within and think that whether we are fulfilling our fundamental duties or not, because every action done today will have its consequences in future. Once again, a very happy Republic Day. Now, I request our guest and staff to go to the Assembly Hall for the tea. Thank you. Jai Hind.
मेरे तेरी शान पे सदके कोई धन है क्या तेरी धूल से बढ़ के तेरी धूप से रोशन तेरी हवा पे जिंदा तू बाग है मेरा मैं तेरा परिंदा है अर्जी दीवाने की जहां बोर सुहानी देखी एक रोज वही मेरी शाम हो कभी याद करे जो जमाना माटी पे मर मिट जाना जिक्र में शामिल मेरा नाम हो
ओ देश मेरे तेरी शान पे सदके कोई धन है क्या तेरी धूल से बढ़ के तेरी धूप से रोशन तेरी हवा पे जिंदा तू बाग है मेरा मैं तेरा परिंदा कोई धन है क्या तेरी धूल से बढ़ के तेरी धूप से रोशन तेरी हवा पे जिंदा तू बाग है मेरा